Shalom, shalom. All praise and glory and honor to the Heavenly Father and His Son through the Holy Spirit. Yahweh, Baruch Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Baruch Hashem, Rekah HaKodesh. Double honors to my apostles and the elders of Great Millstone who rule well. And shalom to the whole elect out there and the elect lady and your children. And what I'm doing right now, and I'm doing a read screen recording. So what you're seeing right now is a screen record that I did today. I did a lesson at 6:29 a.m. in the morning today. And YouTube took my voice out, as always. I'm going to try to screen record the original screen record. And Lord willing, you'll be able to hear my voice, because in my phone, you can hear my voice. But once I download it on YouTube, I don't know what it is. So I'm going to try to screen record the original screen record, which I'm doing right now. Abaratazai, you'll be able to hear my voice. And, Lord willing, you brothers and sisters will be edified through the Spirit. All right, so shalom.
I'm telling you, what he's doing right now is paving the way, the foundation for a new world order. You guys have to listen to this. He said this on September 13th, okay? This month, September 13th, 2024. Take a listen to this.
Because every religion is a way to arrive at God. Sort of a comparison, an example would be there are sort of like different languages in order to arrive at God.
Ma Dio è Dio per tutti.
But God is God for all.
Now, what he's teaching right now, what he's saying is a one world religion. We know the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5, for there was one God and one mediator between God and mankind, the man Christ Jesus. So if you're not going through Jesus, you can't get to God the Father.
Call all Yahweh Shem Yahushai. Call all Yahweh Shem Yahushai. All praise and glory and honor to the Heavenly Father and the Son through the Holy Spirit. Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai Bahashem Rakaha Kudash. Shalom Lubakarium Shaw Yasharala. I want to give double honors to the apostles, my apostles, and the elders of Great Millstone. Shalom to the elect out there and the elect lady and your children. This is only for the house of mourning and for the house of faith, those that truly are sincere and believe in the testimony of our Lord, which is spirit of prophecy, man. All right. Early morning, another day in plantation in Babylon. It's just another day closer to the return of our Lord, Yahweh Shai. And he's definitely coming back. And he's coming back for this demon right here. Now, what you're hearing is, the so-called Pope speaking about a one religion, a one world religion. All right? Through the Spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahshua, we're going to see. Now, these are Christians, and Scripture said, let me go get that real quick. Let me get that. Let's start with that. Because, he's speaking Jesus. We know his name is not Jesus. That's a made-up name. It doesn't exist. But these Christians, let's go to verse 2. All right. Now let's go to verse 1. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Most High for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of the Most High, but not according to knowledge. All right. And that's what's going on right here. A lot of these Christians, they have a zeal. They want to do right, but they're missing so much. And very important is the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai, man. Now, we're going to go into this one order thing, man. Because this is all in the Scriptures, man. One world religion. Come on, man. We know about you devils. I'm going to go right to the point. All right, it's crazy because we're speaking, been bringing out the scripture as of lately. All right, let's go here. Revelation 16:12. And the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water there was dried up. And we know those rivers over there are dried up, man. That the way of the kings of the east might be prepared. So World War III is in the horizon. You know, the dragons of Arabia, you know, the Persians, all right? They're getting ready for war, as it's already started kindling over there in the east in the Levant area. You know, you got the Houthis and Iran and, you know, fair use under the 1976 Copyright Act. I know you demons and devils get down, man. All right, verse 13. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs. Now, when you look at a frog on the earth, you know, a lot of frogs, that you have poisonous frogs. Matter of fact, let's get that real quick. Let's go there real quick, all right? Let's go there real quick. Poisonous frogs, right? Let me see. Damn, I forgot it's spelled. Poisonous. Poisonous frogs. All right. Come on out. Poisonous frogs, all right? Poison dart frogs. You got the golden poison frog. You got the poison dart frog, the strawberry poison dart frog. So we understand that there's poisonous frogs out there, all right? And the reason why I'm bringing this out is because this is what these devils are doing. They're poisoning the minds, you know, of the people on the earth with deception, religion, pagan doctrines of devils, as the scriptures say, man. All right. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon. The dragon represents the Roman Empire, but we understand that we're now in the revised, the new birth, the revival of the old ancient Roman Empire here in Babylon, the Great America, which Esau sits, you know, in his wicked throne. And out of the mouth of the beast, these are synonymous with the beast system. And out of the mouth of the false prophet, all right? And this is the false prophet right here, this demon right here, Pope, whatever, Francis, all right? The demon, he wants a one world religion. Let's go to Colossians. Let me see, I ain't read this scripture in a minute. Colossians chapter 2 and verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Hamashiach Yahweh Shai. All right? See that? So we understand that the beast is speaking, all right? Why? Because they understand that their time is almost up. So they're gonna come down with that great wrath. They're gonna push this new world religion with the new world order. This is what Klaus Schwab has been speaking about, you know, a reset, right? This is all tied up to the beast system. Because they know they only have but a short time, brothers. All right? Let's go to Job 14. And 5. Seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee, thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. Turn from him that he may rest till he had accomplished as a hireling his day. So we understand that this man has an appointed time with Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is going to destroy him. And these elites, and Pope Francis is up there, he's a puppet, you know. They know their time is up, brothers. They know his time is up. They know their time is up.
Father, all right. John 14:16, Jesus answered, I'm the way.
Ain't no damn Jesus, man. Look, you got your wave cap on while you prophesy. And you know, again, you have you these Christians, they have a zeal, but they're not.
The truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. But Pope Francis is telling all these other religions and all these other people and everyone in the world that every religion is a way to arrive to God. Krishna, Buddha.
All right, let's go there real quick. Let's go to the Psalms. Psalms 94 and 6. No. Psalms 96. Hey, what's that? Salakia. Psalms 94. Psalms 96 and 4. For the Lord Yahweh is great and greatly to be praised. When we go into this word, Lord, God, you damn demons, man. Oh, Salakia for that, brothers. Salakia for that, man. All right. God.
Get Covered New Jersey is here to help. Right now, there are low or no cost health insurance options for you and your family. Get.
Satan got to do his thing, brothers. When you go into this word Lord, it's Yahweh. Right? It's all capitals. See it right there? Yahweh. Connector. Yahweh.
Strong's H3068. Yehovah. Yehovah.
Right, we know he's pronouncing it wrong. But anyway, for the Lord Yahweh is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. See? For all the gods of the nations are idols. But the Lord Yahweh made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. All right? This is why this is the demon. This is the devil right here, Pope Francis. All right? He's trying to commemorate. He's trying to bring, you know, all religions together and make a statement that, you know, they all could go and come together, you know, and serve the Lord. No. All the gods, Krishna, Buddha, Muhammad, Allah, all these different, you know, gods that the nations and these heathens praise around the world, no. They're nothing but idols, man. This is why Yahweh Shem Yahushai, you know, told Isaiah this through the vision. Isaiah 19, the oracle concerning Egypt. Remember, the oracles are given to who? All right? These are the prophecies. When you go to Romans, let's go here real quick. Let's go to Romans 3. All right? What advantage then have the Jew? Or what profit is there of circumcision? Much every way, chiefly because that unto them were committed the oracles of the Most High Yahweh Shem Yahushai. All right? Only Israel could be a prophet of the Lord, man. You have to be an Israelite. The oracle concerning Egypt, this is a dark saying for America, the burden of Egypt. Behold, the Lord, Yahweh, rideth upon a swift cloud, and shall come into Egypt, and the idols, remember, the gods of the earth are the gods of the nation are idols, and the idols of Egypt shall be moved at his presence, and the heart of Egypt shall melt in the midst of it. See, and this is what the Heavenly Father is going to do. And these devils, they know their time is up, man. You know. It's just a demon right here.
Guys, we got to really open up our Bibles. We are in these days. We are in these days. Acts chapter 4, Verse 12, salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved.
Yeah, and that name is Yahweh Shai, all right?
Pope Francis kicking off the most ambitious trip of his pontificate with Indonesia, the world's most populous Muslim majority country, where his message centered on how different religions can coexist. The Pope stopping by the largest mosque in Southeast Asia.
And if God is God for all, then we're all sons and daughters of God.
No, you're not. You heathens are not the sons of God. The only sons of God are the Israelites, man. You know, and we're going to go in there. All right? Let's go there real quick. Sons of God. Let me see something. Here we go. All right, let's go to Genesis 5. So let's go to Genesis 4 first. All right? Let's go to Genesis 4. Damn demons, your time is up, man. Time is up, you demons, all right? Genesis 4 and 25, and Adam knew his wife again, and she bare his son, and called his name Seth. For the Most High said, she have appointed me another seed instead of Abel, who Cain slew. And to Seth, to him also, there was born a son. And he called his name Enos. Then began men to call upon the name of the Lord. See, this is the righteous seed line that came through the line of Seth, Adam's son. So these are the righteous seed line. These are the sons of God. It's why when you go to when you go into the story of Genesis 6. It's speaking about the sons of God before they were called Israelites, intermingling, you know, intermingling with, you know, these heathens, man. All right. First Chronicles 1:1, as you can see, the descendants of Adam, Seth, Enoch, Kenan, Mahalal, Jerod, Enoch, Methuselah, Lamech, Noah, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. See, this is the righteous seed line right here. These are the sons of God right here. That's why, let's go back. And Seth, to him also there was born a son, and he called his name Enoch. Then began men to call upon the name of the Lord. This is the righteous seed line, right? Calling and praising, calling upon the name of Yahweh, man. All right? The true sons of God. That's why when you go to Luke, let's go to Luke. Is that one? All right, the angel. Let me see. Now let's go to two. I think it's two, yeah. Or is it three? It's a lock. I think it's three. I'm so sorry. All right. We go to Luke 3. I don't know. Right here. So when you go into this lineage right here, the son of Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, Perez, Arphaxad was the son of Shem. You know, these are speaking about the sons of God, right? Then you jump down to here, let's highlight this real quick. Verse 38 says, which was the son of Enos, which was the son of Seth, which was the son of Adam, which was the son of God. See, these were the sons of God, only coming from the lineage of the Israelites, from Adam. That's why the scripture speaks about that. Let's go to, I didn't read this in a minute. Let me see. Second Ezra 6. Let's go here real quick. To the spirit of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai. All right. Let's go to start at verse 54. All right. Second Ezra 6 and 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, See, when you read the story, there were Adamites on the earth. But the Lord chose a specific Adamite, which was his son. Yahweh Shai. The Lord put his spirit in this man. All right? To be the progenitor, to be the top king on the planet in that garden, to have power and authority over all creatures, including the Adamites that were around. Even though these Adamites represent the trees, you know, they were, you know, in other words, they were heathens before they were called heathens. They were practicing rituals, doing things. But see, the scripture speaks about how the Lord breathed into Adam a living spirit, right? A living spirit, right, brothers? And that spirit, it says, then he became what? A living soul. And that same spirit, it's in us. This is why when you read Ezekiel 37, we were able to stand up on our 2 feet. The sinews and the bones came together, right? Let's go to Job 32. Let's go to Job 32. Where we at right here? Job 32 and 8. But there is a spirit in man, and the inspiration, see, of the Almighty giving them understanding, right? So see, what happened, Adam was given this spirit, Yahweh Shai, all right? This is a special righteous seed line. The Israelites that were called sons of God, even back when Adam was given authority and power on that garden, on the earth. Of him come we all, right? And the people also whom thou hast chosen. See? See this? See, there's a people that's chosen even back then. See, the Lord already established his chosen even from the beginning through the loins of Adam, Adama, right? Even from the loins of Adam, starting with his son, Yahweh Shai. The chosen. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes. And guess what? Adam is about to come back. Yeah. Adam is coming back to establish the world that was given to him in the beginning. Let's go to Romans chapter 5. Let's go there real quick. Romans chapter 5, okay? No, this is Acts 5, so lock it for that. Romans 5, right? Let's go. I'm going to go right to the point. Here we go. Verse 12. Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. For until the law, sin was in the world, but sin is not imputed where there is no law. Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over them that had not sinned after the similitude of Adam's transgression, who is the figure of him that was to come. See, this is our Lord. But not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For if through the offense of one many be dead, much more the grace. See, it goes back to that grace. That's where we stand, right? 1 Peter 5 and 12. That grace, right? Let's go there real quick. 1 Peter 5 and 12. Let's go there. 1 Peter 5 and 12. Let me highlight this. Bear with me. All right? 1 Peter 5 and 11. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. By Salvanus, a faithful brother unto you, as I suppose, I have written briefly, exhorting and testifying that this is the true grace of the Most High Yahweh, wherein ye stand. All right? This is the mercy of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. This is the importance of our Lord Yahweh Shai, because through grace of the Most High Yahweh and the gift by grace, which is by one man, Hamashiach Yahweh Shai, have abounded unto many. And not as it was by one that sinned, so is the gift. For the judgment was by one to condemnation, but the free gift is of many offenses unto justification. For if by one man offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, HaMashiach Yahweh Shai, brothers. Let me jump down. All right, 19, for as by one man disobedience many men were made sinners, so by the obedience of one should many be made righteous, man. All right, so we understand what's going on. Let's go back, 2 Corinthians 6:56. As for the other people, the nations, right, these heathens, right, you know what the Lord says about them. You know, we read 96:4, that the gods of the nation are idols. And this man, this demon, this false prophet over here is trying to bring, this is all the beast system. He's trying to bring everyone under this umbrella of a new world order under the beast system, man. This is all tied up together with the MOTB, man. All right? And Christianity, Catholicism, and all these religions, you stem off of this beast system, not realizing it. Not realizing it, man. All right? But well, let's go. What the Lord said, as for the other people, you nations, right, which also come of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing but be like unto spittle. Spit, man. And has likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel. No importance. These gods of the other nations, these heathens, are not the sons of God. They are looked at as spit. No, the Lord, listen, they're going to be subjugated in the new kingdom to come for all the wickedness they have done. Start with Edom. Verse 57, now, O Lord, behold, these heathen, see, which have ever been reputed as nothing, have begun to be lords over us and to devour us. You know, and Ezra had a lot of questions. You know, he was pissed off. He was looking at the state of Israel being governed and subjugated of these weak-ass heathens. You know, but why? Because we disobedient. We were disobedient. The Lord punished us. Verse 58, but we, thy people, the Israelites, whom thou called thy firstborn, thy only begotten, and thy fervent lover, are given into their hands. If the world now be made for our sakes, why do we not possess an inheritance with the world? How long should this endure? And now we're coming to the end. Now all the questions Ezra, our forefather, you know, was asking the Lord through the archangel Uriel, now they're coming to be fulfilled, brothers. Now we're getting to the end. Now we're getting to the end of the empire of the Edomites, the beast system. This is why the beast is speaking, being wicked, trying to come together with one world religion, right? Let me see something. Let's go here. Second Edges 14:35. Bear with me, brothers. These devils know their time is up, man. All right? I'm going to start at 34. Therefore, if so be that you will subdue your own understanding and reform your hearts, ye shall be kept alive, and after death ye shall obtain mercy, man. And that's going to come to the first fruits, the elect men, right? For after death shall the judgment come, when we shall live again. Call all y'all about Shemi outside, brothers. Reincarnation, there's life after death, the kingdom. Then shall the names of the righteous be manifest, and the works of the ungodly shall be declared. And that's what we're doing. The works of the ungodly, right here. This is an ungodly seed of Satan. This is the seed of the serpent. This is the seed of Cain and Esau, Edom, the deceiver, the devil himself, man. Pope the Francis, the false prophet, right? that unclean frog, that poisonous frog, right, that's infected and has bitten and infected the people on the earth. All right, so we know we are at the end.
Ma il mio Dio è più importante del tuo.
But my God is more important than your God.
È vero quello?
Is that true?
C'è un solo Dio lì.
There's only one God, and each of us is a language, so to speak, in order to arrive at God.
Qualcuno indi, qualcuno cristiano, Indo, Christian. Sono diversi.
Listen to this. The Bible says this in John chapter 1, verse 12. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. You understand me? So those who believed in his name, whose name? The name of Jesus. Then they were given the right.
I hate that name. No name Jesus. Yahweh Shai.
To become children of God. So if you do not receive and believe in Jesus Christ, you are not a child of God. Don't listen to this buffoonery.
Come in.
They're a different path.
Yeah, you're through, man. You're through. All right. God of Israel. All right, let's see something. All right, this should be a lot. I'm looking for something. Okay. First Kings 10 and 6 and 9. Let's get that. Let's go to First Kings chapter 10. All right, this is the story when the Queen of Sheba visits Solomon. You know, all decked out. You know, even his cupbearers, his servants, his door handlers, his doorkeepers, you know, they were decked out. Speaks about, you know, his kitchenware, spoons, forks, cups, they were all made out of silver and gold, you know. And we're going back to that, but on a whole different level, man. May the Most have mercy. Let's read this. I'm going to start at 6. And she said to the king, right, Solomon, it was a true report that I heard in my own land of thy acts and of thy wisdom. See? And she heard about the wisdom of Solomon, and she wanted to inquire. She like, man, look, man, I got to go over there, man. I got to see what's up with this man. Man, I'm listening. I think she's from Ethiopia. I think she has another name, Marquita. All right? I got to go over there and see what's up with this Solomon, man. And this, we're going to get this back. Yahweh is coming back to establish the planet himself, the Jerusalem, his kingdom. And the nations are going to flow into it. It says that in the book of Micah chapter 4. They're going to flow into it. Salakia. They're going to flow into it, man. It's going back, brothers. It's going back to Deuteronomy. Let's go to Deuteronomy. I'm just Deuteronomy 4. All right, I'm going to jump around. Now, therefore, O Israel, unto the statutes and to the judgments which I teach you, for to do them that ye may live and go in and possess the land of the Lord Yahweh of your fathers giveth you. You shall not add unto the word which I command you, neither shall you diminish aught from it, that ye may keep the commandments of the Lord Yahweh which I commanded you. See? Now, when we jump down to 5, behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments, even as the Lord Yahweh, my power, commanded me, that ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it. Keep therefore and do them. For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people, man. For what nation is this so great? Who have the Most High so nigh unto them, as the Lord Yahweh, our power is in all things that we call upon him for. And what nation is this so great that statutes and judgments so righteous as all this law which I set before you this day. Woo! Man. Only take heed to thyself and keep thy soul diligently, lest thou forget the things which thy eyes have seen, and lest they depart from thy heart all the days of thy life, but teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons. And that's where we at. All right. The Lord has wakened us up in the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushua. Now the sons of God are in the scene. We've been taught through the spirit of truth. The Comforter has taught us, brothers. We are the sons of sons. We're the sons of God, going back to the sons of God. But teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons. There's always been a remnant that the Lord preserved in all these captivities that Israel have been to teach these righteous ways, man, to their sons. Always. You had wicked Israelites and you had righteous sons of God that were practicing the laws, they were practicing the righteous ways of the Lord to this day, 2024. You're witnessing the sons being wakened. This is why these nations, they're going to be like, man, woo, I was shy. Look at these Israelites. I love being under these Israelites. I love my master, man. And she said to the king, it was a true report that I heard in my own land of thy acts and of thy wisdom. Howbeit, I believe not the words until I came, and my eyes had seen it, and behold, the half was not told me. Oh, Lord, y'all watch it. Woo, man. I tell you, boy, just endure, brothers. Just endure. Let's just pray for mercy and to endure, because, woo. Man, hey, Paul said it. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. Woo. And behold, the half was not told me. Thy wisdom and prosperity exceeded the fame which I heard. Happy are thy men, happy are these thy servants, which stand continually before thee, and that hear thy wisdom. Blessed be the Lord thy power. Here she goes, she praising Yahweh. Ooh-wee. She is, man. Ooh, these nations, they're going to know. They're going to know that power. Blessed be the Lord, Yahweh, thy power, which delighted in thee to set thee on the throne of Israel. Because the Lord, Yahweh, loved Israel forever. This is a heathen. This is a heathen, brothers. And that's why, hey, look, man, the nation's going to, hey, they're going to know, because the Lord loved Israel forever. Therefore, may he, the king, to do judgment and justice. And she gave the king 120 talents of gold and of spices, very great store and precious stones. There came no more such abundance of spices in these as these which the queen of Sheba gave to King Solomon. You know, and I did some research maybe like a year or two ago on the how much was this, and it was in the millions, put it like that. In today's money, it would be equivalent in the millions. All right, 120 talents of gold. Matter of fact, you guys, you brothers got patience, right? You better. 120. Wait. 120 talents of gold is how much today? All right, 120 talents of gold. All right. How much talents of 24,080 kilograms? All right. Let's go here real quick. So it says, her name was not Sheba, but the queen of Sheba gave him about 120 talents of gold, over 46 million. It's 46 million dollars. Hey, that's why the scripture speaks about tributaries and the kingdom. We're going to set taskmasters. You know, these nations are going to be under our tributaries. All right, brothers. So this is what we're going to receive, brothers. This is why, we are very uncomfortable. Yeah, we're being plagued in the mind. You know, we're going through these trials. We're going through hell. We got all these ailments. You know, we're being vexed by our jobs and our family and people around the world and these, you know, and all of this, man. Yes, it could be very uncomfortable and vexing, brothers. And we hasten the Lord. It's why we hasten in the return of our Lord. This is why we got to continue to prophesy, right? But there's going to be a precious, beautiful kingdom waiting for us. Ooh. You know, and I can't wait. And the Most High have mercy, brothers. You know? But I just wanted to bring that point out. Let's listen up a little bit.
Understood?
Visiting the Tunnel of Friendship, linking it to a nearby cathedral, and sharing this sweet moment with the country's Grand Imam, two leaders practicing what they preach as they called for greater interfaith dialogue. In various regions, we see the emergence of violent conflicts, he said, which are often the result of a lack of mutual respect.
A very important moral voice, Professor Chan, in today's volatile world. Dr. Hedges, perhaps we can bring you into the conversation as well. You know, Pope Francis came with a message of hope, and inter-religious harmony has been a key theme throughout his tour.
I think it's important to stress that this interreligious dialogue is not just a feature of the Pope's visit here in Southeast Asia. This has been a key part of...
So Pope Francis is basically trying to create this religious harmony, which is a one world religion, right? And he's basically trying to teach everyone that we are all God's children and whatnot. But the Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 4,
and you know something, Nimrod tried to do that. And going to that story, Nimrod, he tried to do that, right? Let's go to Nimrod. All right, let me see something. Oh, man, let me see. Let's go to Jeremiah 11 real quick. Bear with me. All right. And the whole earth was one of one language and one speech, man. All right. The Hebrew. All right. When you go here, and they said, these nations, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven. Let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And the Lord said, behold, Yahweh said, the people is one. See, the people is one. And they have all one language. And this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained for them, which they have imagined to do. Go to, let us go down there, confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad the face of all earth, and they left to build the city. Therefore, the name is called Babel, because the Lord did there confound a language all the earth, and thence the Lord scattered them. These are the generations of Shem, or facts that 2 years Shem lived, right? Eber lived, beget Peleg. The word Peleg right here means division. So you can understand there's always been a division. The Lord always divided us, see, division, right? See, that's why, let's go to Deuteronomy 32:8. What the Lord said, when the Most High Yahweh divided to the nations their inheritance, where he's separated, sons of Adam. See, there's always been a separation. All right? You had the righteous seed line and you had the wicked seed line back in Genesis. But through the line of Seth, you know, righteousness was established. The name of the Lord was established. The sons of God started praising the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. But there was always been a separation. That's what holy means. Holy means separation. When you go, let's go to Leviticus chapter 19, right? Verse 1. See? And the Lord Yahweh spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto all the congregation of the children of Israel, and say unto them, ye shall be holy, for I, the Lord, your power, am holy. And it just means separation. The Lord has always separated and divided the righteous from the wicked. And he's doing that right now. He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. For the Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. See? So we go to, let's go to the Apocrypha. Let's go to Sirach 17. You go into the story. It goes into the story of Adam and, you know, the elements and the spirit, right? In verse 10, it said, the elect shall praise his holy name. See? And the elect. All right, because through the sons of Adam, there was an elect that was preserved and chosen out. And those men are being raised up here in these last days. Beside this, he gave the knowledge and the law of life for inheritance. He made an everlasting covenant with them and showed them his judgments. Their eyes saw the majesty of his glory, and their ears heard his glorious voice. And he said unto him, beware of all unrighteousness. And he gave every man commandment concerning his neighbor. Verse 15. Their ways are ever before him and shall not be hid from his eyes. See, the Lord sees everything. Proverbs 15:1 tells you that the eyes of the Lord are everywhere, man, which are the angels, right? Verse 3, the eyes of the Lord Yahweh are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. That's why their ways are ever before him and should not be hid from his eyes. Every man from his youth is given to evil, neither could they make to themselves fleshly hearts, but stony. And we're going into that. You know, the new covenant that's coming, that's going to be perfected when you get those inward. You're going to have the laws in your inward part. And the Lord is going to turn your spirit, your hearts back to flesh. See, the old, under the old rules, the laws were written in stone. And you get that in Ezekiel 36. For in the division, see, this is the point right here. For in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people. But Israel is the Lord's portion, whom being his firstborn, he nourisheth with discipline and giveth him the light of his love. Do not forsake him. Therefore, all their works are as the sun before him, and his eyes are continually upon their ways, man. Call all Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. Let's listen to this.
You are of your father the devil, and you will do, and your will is to do your father's desires. Okay, you can be children of the devil because of how you live your life, what you believe. First John chapter 3.
Yeah, and the Lord was speaking to you Israelites, you know, in John 8. What this Christian is reading, you know, you had a lot of wicked Israelites in that time that didn't believe. You know, they were coming in the spirit of Cain, you know, the serpent. So that's why the Heavenly Father, through the Son, that's why Yahweh was calling them, you are of your father, the devil, man. Just like today, you got Israelites deceiving a lot of Israelites with this false doctrine, this false notion, you know, about we're not supposed to hate Esau, or we're in the new covenant, or, you know, the MOTB is a spiritual, it's spiritual sin or some, you know, these are all man-made pagan doctrines, man. You know, that's why the Lord is going to destroy a lot of you Israelites.
Verse 10, by this it is evident who are the children of God and who are the children of the devil. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor is the one who does not love his brother. For John chapter 3, verse 8, whoever makes a practice of sinning is of the devil.
They're worried about making their rent, about being able to afford groceries. How do you tell someone like that?
Hey, brothers. Yeah, but I promise you, if you ask this man 9 out of 10 what is sin, he's not going to be able to tell you. You know? He's not going to be able to tell you. But we can tell you, 1 John 3 and 4, whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law, for sin is the transgression of the law. All right? And these Christians, they tell you, oh, the law is done away with. I could eat me a shrimp sandwich, you know, eat swine, filth, just food.
His work as the Pope in his role as the leader of sort of all the world sort of Catholics, ever since he's become the Pope, he's wanted to strengthen interreligious relations. And I think we can see in his first stop in Jakarta, where he meets with very important sort of imam there in the largest sort of mosque in the region. And of course, on his last day here in Singapore, he's engaging with youths from many different sort of communities, not just Catholics, at the Catholic Junior College. So sort of, if you like, interreligious dialogue starts and ends his entire tour.
So he is, in fact, a world leader and someone that one should listen to. I was quite
Well, he's the false prophet and the Lord going to destroy his ass. It tells you that. Let's go back to Revelation 16 real quick. All right. Okay. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon and out of the mouth of the beast and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirit of devils working miracles which go forth into the kings of the earth and the whole world. See, this is that new world order. They're trying to manifest and bring to gather them to the battle of that great day of the almighty power, man. All right. So that's why we have to be on our, our P's and Q's, in other words. All right. Because what the Lord said, the destruction is coming. When you read this, the destruction is coming. All right. Let's go into this word false prophet. Let's get this real quick. Hopefully it's together. Let me see. Yep, false prophet. Pseudo prophetis. Pseudo means fake, in other words.
Strong's G, 5578. Pseudo prophetes. Pseudo prophetes.
See, it says one who acting. So this is all an act. This is all an act that the Pope is doing. This is all an act. Acting the part of a divinely inspired prophet utters falsehoods. See? Under the name of divine prophecy, a false prophet. Strong's definition, a spurious prophet, pretended foreteller or religious imposter. All right? That's that witchcraft, a fortune teller, right? A foreteller, right? Say is Greek. That's it. And it tells, oh, look, it goes right to it. Revelation 16 and 10. I saw three unclean spirits. So this is the false prophet. This is
Trump, for instance. In his January address, I saw that he said he was concerned with escalating crisis in the world. And that he was concerned that World War III seemed to be fought piecemeal with so many conflicts growing. So that startled me a bit.
We want peace for the world, especially for the...
Well, there's no peace. There's no peace, but war is coming. All right. Peace will be established once the Lord brings down the devil. All right. Revelation 11 and 14, and it reads, the second woe is past, and behold, the third woe cometh quickly.
In Timor, the Pope facing pressure to address the clergy sex abuse scandal that has rocked the Catholic Church and calling on leaders to prevent every kind of child abuse, but stopping short.
Listen, I won't be surprised if that devil himself is playing with them little boys, man. You know? Straight sick. These are the unclean spirits, brother. Ungodly works. All right? This is the devil, man. Sick. That's why the Lord is going to destroy this place. He's going to destroy this false prophet, this wicked devil. You know? Destruction is coming for this place, man. And they're doing a lot of wickedness in
the
shadow.
The only time you're going to get peace in the world, really, is when the Antichrist comes. He's going to make that 7-year peace treaty break within 3.5.
That's a goddamn lie. All right? There's no 7-year tribulation. This is a false doctrine spoken by the Christian church. The rapture is going to come. There's going to be people that's going to be left behind. They're going to go through a 7-year tribulation when the Antichrist comes in. And guess what? Then they're going to be taken back up. No, the Lord is only coming one time, and that's it. There's no 7-year tribulation. That's some bullshit, man. That left behind doctrine is some bullshit. I did a lesson on that. I studied this shit. You know, when you go into this history, that rapture shit all started by this demon right here. All right? Invention of the rapture, right? You go into this history, this man named by John Darby. You got to go into that history. And he started all that bullshit with the 7-year tribulation. Go into it. John, just type in John Darby. I'm not going to read all of this. But you can go into it, man. All right? No, I got this. Let me see. All right. So. All right. This goes, him that endured to the end. All right. Let's go to Acts 14 and 22. That's why you Christians, man, you're going to learn soon, too, man. You know, you're going to learn. You're going to learn the hard way. What it says, Acts 14 and 22, confirming the souls that are the disciples. Let's read the verse 21. And when they had preached the gospel to that city and had taught many, they returned again to Lystra and to Iconium and Antioch, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith. And that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of the Most High. We got to go through that hell. Got to go through the straight gate, man. All right? So when you go into these scriptures, it tells you about that, the great tribulation. All right? You know, the Lord is only coming one time, brothers.
I feel like the Antichrist is going to come and promise peace and all this stuff.
Yeah, they believe in one Antichrist. What the scriptures say? Let's go. Man, call all y'all about seeing yourself for this truth, brothers. All right. Let's go to what did the scriptures say? All right, let's 1 John 2:18. Little children, it is the last time, as ye have heard, that Antichrist shall come. Even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time, and we're definitely living in the last time. All right? There's not one Antichrist that's going to, rule. No, anti just means against Hamashiach Yahushua. his testimony, like, his doctrine.
And the peace he's going to promise is going to be through one world religion.
Specifically referring to clergy abuse or issuing any apology. Last stop, Singapore, where Catholics are in the minority. The Pope circling back to that message of religious harmony, saying Singapore sets an example for the rest of the world.
Everyone has the right to practice their religion. Everyone lives harmoniously here.
A 12-day, four-country, two-continent journey that came amid concerns for his health.
We want to show you some extraordinary pictures which came to us from the Vatican on what was, of course, an extraordinary day. Within hours of Pope Benedict announcing that he was to resign, take a look at this. Lightning struck St. Peter's Basilica. You can see it again now in slow motion.
You know, Pope Francis is indeed a antichrist. He's not the antichrist, but he is a antichrist. He's like this.
You see, he just cut himself, all right? He just proved that there are many antichrists. It just means to be against the doctrine of Yahweh Shai, the testimony of our Lord. But then he goes and says, but he's not the antichrist. There's not one man. No, these are devils, man.
Dude is like a forerunner. He's like a forerunner of the antichrist. Listen, if you guys are Catholic, this should be every sign for you to get out of Catholicism.
I don't want to listen to no more, man. Anyway, man, Lord willing, you are edified. Abba Ratzai, you are edified through the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. All praise and glory and honor to the Heavenly Father and His Son through the Holy Spirit, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, Baha Shem Rekai HaKadosh, Shalom Lubakarim Shor Yasharala. Double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well. Shalom to the elect out there and the elect lady and your children. This is only for the house of mourning and for the house of faith, those that are sincere and truly believe in the testimony of our Lord, which is spirit of prophecy, man. Abba Ratzai, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, Shalom. All praise and glory and honor. Salaki for that delays. Shalom, brothers. Lord willing, they'll upload it.